You're listening to Health Professional Radio with Wayne Buckler. My guest today is Stephen Eddine. Stephen's a qualified nutritionist and a naturopath, and he is the principal of Australia's longest established natural medicine college, Health Schools Australia. He's completed a Bachelor of Complementary Medicine, as well as a Master's in Health Science and a PhD in Nutritional Medicine. Stephen joins us today from their Queensland location. Stephen, welcome to Health Professional Radio.
It's great to be here.
Now, Stephen, we've had a chat before about various complementary medicines, but today we want to talk about ubiquinol.
Yes, ubiquinol is a wonderful natural medicine that can help many people with a great amount of, you know, to improve their energy levels.
Now, this is already naturally inside our bodies, isn't it?
It is. Our body makes a small amount of ubiquinol, and we also get a small amount through our food. And we can also supplement that to top up to become optimal levels, to get optimal levels in our body.
Okay, so is there research to support this, the benefits of ubiquinol?
One of the great things I like about ubiquinol is the research, because it shows quite effectively that by supplementing with ubiquinol, we can improve our performance, our energy levels, and our cardiovascular function, as well as it being a terrific antioxidant as well.
Now, there is a headline in my brief here that I read that I love, and it talks about inflammation in 100 Spanish firemen. Now, I have a picture of 100 Spanish firemen bursting into flames here. Are you familiar with the bit of research?
Yeah, it's terrific, isn't it? I love that. I love all the ubiquinol research. Has some, you know, like there's a whole lot of marathon runners in one research and all sorts of things. It's terrific.
Now, apparently, there's been double-blind research done in rugby players and in athletes and in all sorts of people. What are the benefits the research is indicating for ubiquinol, Stephen?
Sure. The main benefit and the theme is around athletics and athletes. And what happens when you're an athlete and you take ubiquinol, your performance improves. You get a lot more energy to be able to function at your top. And percentage-wise, it increases by 3 to 5% depending on the study you read. And that mightn't sound like too much, but for me, I run marathons. Now, if I just even improve my marathon running by 2.5%, then I'm going to be a kilometre ahead of where I would be without ubiquinol. So it is quite a dramatic improvement.
And I understand it's also prescribed by some cardiologists for people who are on statins. And I guess for many people in my generation, statins is a pretty common medication.
Oh, common is an understatement. It is the most common medicine prescribed in Australia today. And the statins actually reduce the body's production of ubiquinol, so supplementing it is almost a necessity when you're taking statin medications.
And what's the impact of that reduced ubiquinol, Stephen?
Well, the main one is reduced energy levels. You get vastly reduced energy levels when your ubiquinol levels drop, but also you start to become forgetful, and you also get a lot of muscle pain, and that occurs dramatically when you have low ubiquinol levels in the body, and that's why supplementation when you're on a statin medication is ideal. And of course, check with your medical doctor about that before you take any supplementation.
And I guess that, you know, a lot of statins are prescribed to people in their 60s when, you know, some muscle pain and some lack of energy and some decrease in cognitive function is kind of easy to put down to just getting old.
Well, that's the sad thing, you know. People say, oh, you know, you're just getting old, and they go, no, my pain, and you know, and you say to these people, if you're getting old, you probably need to exercise more, but oh, but I can't, there's no energy, and it's like, oh, well, you're getting old, and you're absolutely correct, and that's a problem, because if you're confusing the two, then, you know, supplementing with ubiquinol is a really simple way to improve the health of someone beyond their just, you know, cardiovascular health and improve their energy levels. So, of course, once their energy levels increase, they can therefore go to the gym and start getting on with life and improving the quality of their life, which is what we're all chasing.
Now, Stephen, is this something you need a prescription for, or is it an over-the-counter medicine, or do we have to eat a lot of green leafy vegetables and celery stems, or how do we go about boosting this?
Sure. Of course, you know, you can go about eating a lot of healthy foods, but you need to eat about 4 kilograms of chicken to get the optimal amount of ubiquinol. So the best way and the simplest way is it's an over-the-counter natural medicine, and you can get it from a pharmacy or any natural medicine or naturopath. Just ask for ubiquinol and not ubiquinone. There's two forms of CoQ10. Ubiquinol, the OL on the end, is the most beneficial form because it is the most reduced form, and that's the active form, and that's the one that's found in the body. So that's the one we aim for.
And you just mentioned CoQ10 there. Can you explain that?
Sure. CoQ10 is either ubiquinol or ubiquinone. And CoQ10, the active form of CoQ10 is ubiquinol, which is what we're talking about today. There is an oxidized form, which is called ubiquinone, and that's a cheaper version, but it's not effective in the body. We need that supplement to be activated in the body. But what I recommend to my patients is you just take the reduced or the active form straight away so you get the greatest benefits from it.
See, there's always another little thing to know in this world, isn't there? I would have looked at the labels and gone, yeah, they're both pretty similar, that'll do.
Yeah, and that's the problem, because then you know, your average, you know, person takes the ubiquinone form, the non-active form, and they don't get any benefit from it. And then they come in to see me and they go, oh, I've tried that CoQ10 stuff and it doesn't do me any good. I don't feel any different on it. And, you know, that's sad, because then you try to convince them this ubiquinol is a better form, and they look at you like you've got two heads. And unfortunately, yeah, that's a big problem, because people do get the wrong form and they don't get any benefit from it.
Now, I notice here in my brief today, Stephen, there's a line that says ubiquinol is present at high levels in healthy sperm, and it's now being used as a supplement to help boost male sperm count. But representing the generation on statins, I don't think that's an issue for me.
Yeah. Well, as you know, sperm swim, and swimming requires a lot of energy, and the little tail in a sperm is where all the mitochondria, or energy-producing parts of the cells, are. So that's, of course, where ubiquinol is in high concentration. So it actually helps the sperm move and swim. And so that's where ubiquinol is beneficial for fertility. It makes your sperm more potent as well. So that's the side effect of it. That's a good side effect, obviously.
I'll drop a note to my children and grandchildren about that one, I think.
Yeah, sure.
Stephen, many of our audience are clinicians who are working in acute care and aged care. Is there a message you'd like them to take away from having heard our chat today?
Sure. Look for the active form of CoQ10, which is ubiquinol with the OL on the end. That's the take-home message. That's the one with all the research. That's the one that will give you the energy, and it will improve your sperm as well. So there you go.
If you've just missed my conversation, I've been having another chat, as I often do, with Stephen Eddy. Stephen's the principal of Health Schools Australia, and has a Bachelor of Complementary Medicine and a Master's in Health Science and a PhD in Nutritional Medicine, and is our go-to guy when we're talking complementary medicines. The good news is we've got a transcript of our conversation available for you on our website at www.hpr.fm, or you can listen to the interview again on both SoundCloud and YouTube, and there are links to that on our website. Stephen, it's been a pleasure having you with us once again. Thanks for joining us.
And it's great to chat. And chat anytime too.
My pleasure. You're listening to Health Professional Radio. My name is Wayne Buckler.